Hi, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Bhavika Bhaguna, and I'm HR manager of. Hello. Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Yes, sir. My name is Bhavika Bhaguna, and I'm HR manager of Air Cruise Aviation Private Limited. And here on the screen, you can see my social media handles as well. You can follow me up on those. My LinkedIn, Facebook, and Instagram all are here. So basically, I'll be talking about Sri Lankan Airlines cabin crew. So points which I'm going to cover in the entire slide is introduction to Sri Lankan Airlines and Sri Lankan Airlines cabin crew. And the second thing is the requirements that are required for requirements to be done for cabin crew. And the third is benefits that you are going to get after you enter in Sri Lankan Airlines as a cabin crew. And last, some of the questions and answers that you have to go through before getting into it, and after, and you'll be interviewed accordingly on those questions and answers. So first of all, cabin crew is also divided among five things, like ground and flight attendant, senior flight attendant, cabin services supervisor, and purser. These are the five heads. These are the five subheads that you are going to get into after you get into Sri Lankan Airlines as a cabin crew. So here is the introduction to it. Sri Lankan Airlines, it's a reputed airline wherein they have got excellency in their services, safety, reliability, their comfort, and punctuality. They don't compromise on, especially on the punctuality thing. So there are large number of opportunities that are that Sri Lankan Airlines are giving all the aspiring cabin crews. And they are giving the chance to work in such a nice work environment. They have got a nice work environment to work in, so that none of the cabin crew find any problem regarding it. So cabin crew is like a brand ambassador of their national career, and it's for extending the warmth of Sri Lankan hospitality on board. So next is, what are the requirements for getting into cabin crew of Sri Lankan Airlines? So the first is, the candidate should be a Sri Lankan citizen. And the second is, his or her age is between 20 to 25 years. And the third is, he or she should be single. And the fourth point, they should be fluent in their English. And the last point is, minimum height that is required is 157.5 centimeter. So there are more requirements for it, but major requirements are these only. So here are the benefits of Sri Lankan Airlines if you join Sri Lankan Airlines as a cabin crew. So there are two types of allowances or the additional benefits that are with the basic salary. You'll be getting the basic salary, but here are additional benefits to it. The first one is monthly fixed allowances. And the second is monthly variable allowances. Fixed allowances are like, it's like fixed for you for the entire year or for entire your work experience, the time you will, for the your entire tenure that you will be working in. And the second is variable allowances. It might differ from month to month or year to year, or it might also differ on the basis of your cabin crew subheads. So first is, in the fixed allowances, first is special premium allowance. That is only applicable to C3. C3, I told you here, C3 senior flight attendant, and the C4 is cabin services supervisor, and C5 is purser. So it's only, this special premium allowance is only applicable to these three. And grooming allowance, language proficiency allowance. It's for per language. Language proficiency allowance is for per language. And the fourth is fee allowance. These are the fixed allowances that you will be getting per month. And the second, that variable allowances, meal allowance, overnight allowance for hotel, transport, home pickups and drops are provided. These are variable allowances. These can be as per the needs of the cabin crew and whatever they feel like, if they want to take or not. These are the variable allowances. So now questions and answers that as a cabin crew interviewer or as a Sri Lankan Airlines interviewer can ask you. So the first is, tell me something about yourself. So over here, it's like a first and foremost thing. Everyone, whoever is going to be interviewed, so they are going to get this question for the very first. It's for maximum times that they'll be getting. So you can start. You have to be very professional, and it's a way like interviewer can know you, but professionally. They won't be like, where if you are from here, so they can get into more deep details, but they are, it's a professional way of communicating between interviewer and interviewee. So, and the basic thing is, start with I am, my name is, like this. Never, don't ever use myself. Myself, it's like, it's grammatically incorrect, and it will be a bigger blunder for if you are in the interview and you are saying myself, Bhavika Bahugna, if you are saying like this. So this is it. You can even tell them from where you belong to, what's your graduation, why you did that course in the graduation, and you can even relate it to your cabin crew for the post you are applying for. You can relate it to that. And then you can tell them your schooling, and you can tell them your unique thing that interests you. From the schooling or from the graduation that took you to from there to coming for interview. So these are, you can tell them about all these things. But the thing should be in brief. Don't make it more, don't extend it. Like the second is strengths and weaknesses. So what are your weaknesses and strengths, XYZ? They can ask you like that. So you have to tell your strength areas and how it can, and please relate it to your this cabin crew, the interview you are applying for. Here you are applying for cabin crew, so you can even relate your strength as well as weakness that to cabin crew, and what are your weaknesses that you can work upon before entering into cabin crew. So the third is languages that you can speak. So so that interview can know for the, it's for just as well as cabin crew. Like if any passenger is speaking in it's, he's not able to speak in English. So people, even the cabin crew should know that this person is not able to speak in English. So his fellow mates, his fellow mates can let someone to get into to help the passenger. To help the passenger in speaking in Hindi. So this is, and fourth question that can ask is, why aviation industry? Why you are applying over here? If you have done, if someone has done, suppose he has done or she has done BTEC in his graduation. So first and foremost thing that comes to interviewer mind is, why don't you go for engineer or various things like even you can go for defense. You are applying for this. You have done your BTEC. So why aviation industry and why cabin crew? So you have to tell them that what attracts you about the industry, about the aviation industry. And you can, that is that you can attract, what attracts you more, and you can tell them that you love meeting people, you love traveling and all these things. And now, why cabin crew? So Over here, interviewer wants to know like how dedicated and how self-motivated you are for becoming cabin crew. So you can tell them your hobbies, or like you love traveling and want to explore the world. So, and you can tell them about any person who inspires you about joining it. You can tell about it, all these stuff. Six question could be, what are the duties and responsibilities of a cabin crew member? So by this question, interviewer wants to know like how much you are well known with the cabin crew as a cabin crew member, how much you know about their duties and responsibilities. So you can tell them like cabin crew members are basically, they just represent the airlines they are working for. So you can tell them like ensuring that flight cleanliness and working, there is proper working of safety equipments, and they inform passengers about safety measures and check whether passengers are seated properly without being in trouble like this. And after, at last, you have to prepare a flight report after the flight. So these are some of the basic duties and responsibilities. What do you think are your best qualities for a cabin crew? So by this, interviewer would be testing you if you are suitable for cabin crew or not. This according to you, what could be the best qualities that are required for being a cabin crew? So you can tell them like adaptability is required, teamwork is required, work ethic is required. Like these all questions you can tell them, like some of the points you can tell them. So here, what according to you are the skills required for a cabin crew? So in my previous slide, I told you what do you think are your best qualities? You can tell them about your best qualities that are required for cabin crew. But in this, you have to tell them like what skills are actually required for being a cabin crew. So by this question, interviewer would be testing your basic knowledge of the skills that for the post you have applied for. So customer service, multitasking, cabin crew should be more into customer service, multitasking, decision making, all these things you can tell them. So this is it. My name is Bhavika and I have presented Sri Lankan Airlines as a cabin crew.